2 years ago, I was part of a National Science Foundation reconnaissance team sent to this earthquake-ravaged area in central Italy.
A series of earthquakes completely leveled this city to the point where almost nothing is standing anymore.
When we went back, it was almost like a time machine.
Seeing just everything left, in large part, exactly how it was right after that earthquake happened, was very sobering.
There's just not a lot of resources available to rebuild these communities.
We're back to try to understand some more information about the earthquake and to train some students on how to fly drones for the purpose of infrastructure monitoring.
Using the drones, we're able to get footage of whole cities and be able to tell exactly what areas were affected most.
The drones are really useful in this because we're able to get the 3D models that have a lot of detail, a lot of imagery. They're a really amazing tool to be able to use.
We try to find ways that the drones can be intelligent and do their own work rather than us having to constantly fly them.
A normal drone flight, it's gonna go back and forth with taking pictures looking straight down.
And we don't want the drone to just go to a certain elevation and take images vertically.
We're doing an optimized algorithm that we're incorporating into our flight paths to make better models.
The algorithm, it's the only one like it, actually. It can look at the different slopes and the elevations, and it can tell the drone to move up and down and turn.
We want the drone to go everywhere around that hill and take only the number of photos necessary so that nothing gets missed.
We're going to test our optimized flight path algorithm using the Phantom 4 drone.
This is all of the points for Pescara del Tronto that the optimization algorithm selected for the optimized flight.
Instead of walking around a building and taking pictures from the ground, now we can run a flight path and model a city.
You can't see it, it's right up there, but that thing is flying itself.
We can go in now to a city, collect all the information we need in a matter of 2 hours, and come back, develop a three-dimensional model of that city, and then study and analyze it.
This software makes connections between all the photos. By doing that, they can then go in, make a sparse cloud of what all the geometry is. Then they reuse that to make a dense cloud that has literally millions of points.
That's how we're able to create these really highly accurate and beautiful and useful 3D models.
If you're monitoring something, you need to know if it moves, you know, down to the inch. We can measure that there's a crack forming somewhere. And so that actually gives the engineers the ability to do our analysis.
They're going into these models. They're finding things that are of interest. They're bringing in the broader engineering community and getting their opinions. And it's just beginning.
Almost anything you can think of, we can put a drone with it and make it better, in my opinion. And as it gets better, you know, we're gonna save more lives.
With the Inspiring Learning Initiative, more students are being given the opportunity to go to these places and be able to see what it is that we're actually studying. These are people's lives. These are people's homes.
It changed the priority and the way I write code to be able to work out in the real world. Being on site really just puts it all in perspective of what we actually are here for.
Realizing as an engineer, doing more than just flying a drone or solving a math problem, but you're impacting people's lives.